Hey guys, it's Hannah and welcome back to the Dyslexic Reader. Today I'm going to be doing my wrap up for the Booktubeathon 2017. I managed to finish all 7 books, all 7 challenges, and I read about 1,617 pages, I think. I was aiming to try and get 17,000 since it's 2017. But I got my 17 in there still, and next year maybe I can aim for 1,800 words, but or pages even. But anyway, I'm just going to give you a quick wee overview on what I thought on all the books that I read this week. These are in no particular order, so I'm just going to start off with this since I've got the picture up on my iPad because I listened to this on audiobook, and this was just my 7th book, When You Reach Me Right by Rebecca Steed. This is a book about a young girl who starts receiving weird letters, and it becomes clear that the letters have been written by someone in the future who is looking answers from the past. And there's a whole lot of stuff going on, and this guy seems to know things that are yet to happen, but he's asking for stuff that has already happened, and it's all very weird, and it's just a really good fun read. I just listened to it on audiobook when I was driving or doing the dishes, and I really enjoyed it. I just thought it was a good kids read that really any age could listen to, and it had some really good sort of messages in it, and I would give it a 4-star. The next book that I've just got in my pile here is Kevin by KD Reid. This is Kim from Kim Here, whose channel I will link down below. This is quite a little short book. I done it in my read in under 24 hours, which of course I did. It's about 60 pages, and I could give this nothing but 5 stars. My only issue was it wasn't long enough. Like, I wanted to know so much more about the characters. Like, I could read a series that was based around these characters. It's based in New York, and it's sort of like Earth is being used as a jail for aliens, and Kevin is one of the aliens who has been sent to Earth to live out his sentence, and they're sort of just abandoned on Earth. They're not given any money or resources or places to live, and it's up to them to try and find somewhere and whether they want to like help each other out or not. And Kevin's dumped on Earth, and some other aliens like come, and they sort of start a family, and it's a really beautiful message, and it's quite thought provoking, and it's well written, and I loved the characters. I thought the characters developed, even though it was so short, we saw development in the characters, and yeah, Kevin writes on more of this. It was so good. The next book I read was Frankenstein by Mary Shelley. This was a buddy read that I carried out with Barbara from Treehugger Spiderling, and I'll link her channel down below. We read this together. We'd done it over 2 days, and we split it just roughly down the half, and we conversed a couple of times a day to see how we were getting on. We both hated this book. Barbara had tried to read it before and didn't really like it and DNF'd it, and when I said I was doing it in my TBR, she said she would like to give it another go, so I was like, let's do it together. So it wasn't good. The writing was bad. It didn't have any of the sort of sci-fi fantasy things that I had come to expect of the book, which I understand the book's not going to be like the movies, but at the same time, like, there was no sort of creepy castles, Igor with a hunchback, lightning storms, he's alive kind of type moments. The first sort of half an hour, I would say, I don't know what the page number is, was letters to this guy who wasn't really from this guy, who wasn't relevant to his story, to his sister, who was more, even more irrelevant to the story. Frankenstein was a horrible character. He was such a moan. Like, he done all this bad stuff, and I was like, all this bad stuff is happening. Like, it was so moany. The monster was weird. I thought this could be heavily edited. And Mary Shelley was only about 18 when she wrote this, and it's so apparent. I thought it was juvenile and the writing style wasn't good. So sorry about it. But I checked it off my list. It was something I've been wanting to read for a long time, and now I know. This was my read a book that's about someone very different from me. Then I read Treasure Island by R.L. Stevenson, and this was also a 2-star. I give Frankenstein like a 1-star. It was awful. This was a 2-star for me. I think I would have liked it more, and I think Frankenstein would have been the same. I think it's the same for a lot of the classics. I think I would have liked it more if I had not known what was going to happen, if you know what I mean. Like, I never watched Treasure Island the movie or anything, but I love Treasure Planet, like the Disney Intergalactic version. So I sort of knew what was going to happen. I thought parts of it, again, were boring. It could have been edited out. And there was a lot of scenes when they were on the island. I was just like a day of how they got by. Like, I didn't really need to know that. They didn't have to be in it. I like the characters, but as a dyslexic, reading accents is incredibly hard, like almost impossible. So a lot of the pirate talk in this, I really, really struggled with. I would say I didn't get at least 40, maybe to 60% of the dialogue that was going on in this book. And I was sort of just skimming it and trying to get the gist of it as I could because I can't sound out words. So it's, unless it's a word that's in my head, I don't know how to read it. So there was no way that I could read the sort of made up words, like as it was spelt as a pirate would say it, if you know what I mean. And I can't sound those out, and it was incredibly difficult for me. And I think that let the story down as well. So I think if I took out the issue I have with the dialogue, it might have been a 3-star because I liked the characters and it was a good story, even though I found it a bit boring in parts. But the dialogue really killed it for me. For a book with a person on the cover, I read Bigfoot, Tobin and Me by Melissa Savage. This is known as Lemons. In the US, it's about a little girl called Lemonade and her mother dies. So she goes to live with her grandfather, and she's from San Francisco and is used to the city, and she obviously moves to a rural setting, and she befriends this little boy called Tobin, who is the head of the Bigfoot Detective Agency and is obsessed with finding Bigfoot. This story is beautiful. It deals with grief in such an honest, true, but simple, understandable way. I done for my day 5 challenge where you had to do the reading list for a class. I done it all about helping children to cope with grief and how grief can be coped incredibly well in children's literature. And this was the book that inspired me sort of to do this. It was talked about beautifully. It was talked about like a volcano, and it got so hot you couldn't breathe, and sometimes the volcano spewed out and you did mean things and said mean things, but it was completely involuntary. And it talked about sadness as a quicksand that you could get sucked into and you needed a hand to pull you out. And it was just some really beautiful metaphors. And me losing my grandfather, who was an immensely huge part of my life, a couple of weeks ago, I found at the start this hard to read, but by the end of it, I really think it sort of helped me get through a bit of the grieving. That sounds weird, but I felt that I could really relate to the characters because Lem has lost her mother, but all of the characters are going through loss in a certain way. And I really found myself by the end really relating and really caring for it. I would say, again, maybe I'm just in this sort of mood, it could have been 80 pages shorter and wouldn't have lost any of the story. But absolutely beautiful, and I would give it 4.5 stars. If Goodreads done 1/2 stars, so. But yeah, 4.5 stars, definitely. Very, very close to 5. Apart from that issue of it being a bit long, especially at the beginning. For my read a book because of the cover, I don't cover buy. I normally buy all my books second hand, or like in second hand shops or second hand online, so cover really isn't a factor. But I did see this whole series in a charity shop for cheap, and they all have matching covers, and the matching covers helped me to invest in the whole series. Normally I wouldn't do that, but they were there and they were really cheap, and I knew I would like them to a certain degree, and they had matching covers, so I'm going to count that. I read Ruby in the Smoke, which is the first Sally Lockhart book by Philip Pullman. This was amazing. I can't believe I have never read any of Philip Pullman's work before. None of his adult books, the sort of plot line, never really enthused me to read any of him. This is more of a, I wouldn't say children's, but verging on young adult, sort of late teens. The main character's about 16, I would say it's for that sort of age range, and it's a Victorian mystery, which is completely up my alleys. A lot of it centered around an opium den. Completely up my alley. And it was fantastic. The writing in this was so good. I was so hooked. I don't know if it's maybe because I haven't read a book like this in a while, and this is like my go-to. What started me on readings mostly mysteries, but especially Victorian mysteries, like Sherlock Holmes is my bae. So I don't know if it's because I haven't read anything like this for a while and I just love it so much, but I found the writing in this incredibly good and the story was good too. I didn't see all the twists coming at the end, the major ones I got, but there were some little subplot twists that caught me off guard, which I thought were really nice. The one issue I did have is a 16-year-old girl's having a relationship with like a 21-year-old man, which I thought was a little bit weird to put in a children's book, but I guess it's Victorian London, so you know, worse things were going on. But even despite that, this is a 5-star. It was so good. And last but not least, read a book completely outdoors. I was dubious of this challenge, but I actually did manage to complete it on, I think, about Wednesday. I got like 20 minutes of sunshine, and I purposely picked a graphic novel because there's no read way you could ever get to read a book outside in Northern Ireland. Like, there is no way. We're lucky to get 20 minutes without rain. We've had like thunder and lightning storms for like the past 3 days, and it's been impossible to get out. But I read The Vicar Woman by Emma Randell. Randell, I think. This was, I saw this first on Hannah Tay's channel, which again I will link down below. It's about this lady vicar who goes to this little island, and a little girl has been abused in some way on the island, and the vicar doesn't really know what's happening. Everyone's telling her different stories, but they're very quick to admit that it wasn't their fault. And you find out that sort of everyone sort of knew what was going on, but no one stepped in to help this girl, and they're sort of being torn apart by the guilt that they have. The writing, the drawing style is very weird. Like, they're all sort of like, very few of them are like actually human-esque. Like, a lot of them, like, there's a bird beak, there's a big Pinocchio nose. I'm not sure what that is. That one's like a fox. Like, some of the characters are very weird, and just the general art style is a bit funny. But this was harrowing. It was so sad. It really struck a chord with me, I think, as someone who works with children. The fact that people would see such horrific things happening to a child and not step in is really mind-blowing to me. And yeah, I think this was not a fun read, but it was good. It was done, I don't think it could be portrayed in a novel. I think graphic novel was the perfect format for it because you sort of had to, it wasn't all explained, you were just getting the dialogue, and from the pictures you had to put them sort of together and work out the whole picture to yourself, which I think worked really well. So everyone would get out of the book, you know, something different. And yeah, it was very dark and sad, and I think this is going to impact me for a long time, but in a good way. And I'll definitely be, I bought this copy for myself, it's not out of the library, and I'll definitely be loaning this to family and friends because wow, what a shocker. That was the books that I read for the Booktubeathon 2017. I hope you all had fun if you participated and you enjoyed seeing my little wrap up. My general July wrap up will be up in the next day or so, so keep an eye out for that. I hope you're all happy, I hope you're all healthy, and I'll see you in my next video. Goodbye.